So guys, in this video we are going to take a look at this tool called LDAP domain dump, and this tool is written in Python, so it's easy to install using pip. And this tool is the post exploitation tool. So this tool expects the administrator password of the domain or any other user password. So let's go ahead and install this tool, pip3 install LDAP domain dump. So I have already installed this tool, so you just install this using this command. So all I need to do is, and it's a sudo ldap domain dump, so I will specify this minus h to get the help page. So we need to give username, password, and the I think the IP address. So that's it, the host tab. So let's go ahead and, so my active this server is running here, as you guys can see. So let me ping this one. So we have put the static IP, right? So let's try to ping. So it's working. So let's go ahead and specify the username, and we need to specify like this the NetBIOS name, home lab, and the administrator. So then we need to specify the password, and finally we need to specify the IP address. So your domain dump has been finished. So let me say ls. So it has created in the current directory. So let me remove this one. So let's make another directory, say ldap underscore dump. So let us run the command again. So now we can see the different file formats, HTML, grepable format, you can use with the grep, and HTML and JSON. So we got the domain computers, domain groups, domain policy, domain trust, and domain users. So let's go to File Explorer and open this in Chrome, and let's see what the information we have got. So let's first start with the users. As you guys can see, we have got the users, CAC admin user 1, and this Kerberos ticket guaranteeing server, and the guest and administrator. So guys, you can see the here groups also, and created on the user creation date and changed last log on, and flags, password asset, SID, and description. So let me click on this CAC1. Let's see, we got the domain users by group. So these users have been grouped in by their groups. We have the administrators and domain admins and enterprise admins group. Domain guest, there is only one guest account, and read only domain controller, we have these users, and enterprise admins, we have the administrator, and domain users, so these users can log on to the domain. So we have CAC admin user 1. So schema admin, so administrator is only the admin for the schema, and group policy, creator owners, administrator, and CAC 1 user 1. CAC 1 is the group we have created previously. And the guests is a default group, and users and domain admins. So these are the groups we have by default, and also when we have created. So now let's open this domain computers. and we have only the Windows 7 computer. You can see the virtual machine and win7.homelab.server and Windows DC, the current Windows Server machine. And you can see the service pack OS version. Suppose if you have so many accounts, so many computers like XP and Windows 7, and you also get the OS version, right? So in this is a very small domain. I don't have that much computer power to run the 3 or 4 or 5 virtual machines. So generally in the domain there will be so many computers. So if there will be like identical computers, so if one is a Windows 7, then everything will be Windows 7, right? Suppose it's like because they have to manage with this DC domain controller, so that's why our computer will be identical. So if one computer can be exploited, then every computer can be exploited. So as you can see, workstation account created on and it's zip. So guys, that's all for this LDAP domain dump video. You can also see these policies and address as well. So this tool is a post exploitation tool. If you have the password, and you can almost get most of the information from the domain.